Now, zinc does so many things. It's involved in over 300 different pathways. But recently, I found out that zinc has an unexpected sleep benefit. Typically, when you think of a zinc deficiency, you think of a child not growing very fast, or someone having low testosterone, or they can't taste or smell, or they have poor wound healing, or a poor immune system, or even they may develop an ulcer. But one huge symptom for a lack of zinc is poor sleep. So zinc has a major influence over the central nervous system. In fact, it's the second most abundant trace mineral in your brain. It's involved in neurotransmitters, which are those hormone communications that travel through the nervous system. It's also essential for making adenosine. Now, what is adenosine? Adenosine is that molecule that gradually builds up through the day and creates sleep pressure. It's that compound that controls pressure that pushes you into the deep sleep. And all night long when you're sleeping, adenosine breaks down and then you become awake, right? Also, caffeine blocks adenosine, and that's why caffeine makes you more awake. But zinc will help you build up more adenosine, which is sleep pressure. Zinc is also involved in making dopamine. It's also involved in making serotonin, which then turns into melatonin, the sleep hormone. Also, zinc is involved in certain biochemical pathways involving glutamate, which has a profound effect on deep sleep. So, zinc is what is called a sleep modulator. It helps control sleep. Now, anytime you take zinc, I also recommend you take it with copper in a certain ratio. So, for every 8 to 10 milligrams of zinc, you want to take 0.5 to 1 milligrams of copper. And 0.5 milligrams of copper is 500 micrograms. So, roughly, you'd want 10 times more zinc than you do copper. And I also recommend taking that zinc copper in a blend of trace minerals. Now, out of all the food that you can eat, oysters have the highest amount of zinc. And also, oysters are loaded with taurine, which is not only good for increasing your physical performance, but it's also good for your sleep cycles. And oysters also have something called GABA receptor agonist. Now, what is that? That is something that activates GABA, okay? And GABA is all about calming the nervous system down, helping you sleep. And it's been found that people with shorter amount of sleep have significantly less zinc than those people who can sleep longer. And lastly, the blood-brain barrier has low permeability for zinc. So if you're very deficient in zinc, you're just not going to sleep. So it really helps to beef up, no pun intended, your zinc supply. All right, so there's many things you can do for sleep. And zinc is definitely one thing to add to the list.
Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.